Now, in the views of the new Sony A7S3 firmware, some creators and some other people over the this internet platform discovered that there is a problem with the raw signal, ProRes signal, especially when you record on your output. Obviously, ProRes RAW to the Ninja 5. Apparently, we have lost the capability to get clean shots at ISO 12800. Now, let me start with a little bit of history. I would say that Sony A7S3 that was launched in 2019 was a breakthrough in the Sony Alpha series. It was the first camera that was able to shoot 10-bit in S-Log, not only 4K 60 that everybody wanted, because previous camera would have shoot only 4K 30 in 8-bit, but we now are able to shoot 4K 120 with a minimal crop like 1.1, which is negligible. We have the full HDMI, two slots, SD card that can go up to V90, which is absolutely amazing. We have a flip-out screen and capability to output ProRes RAW. Now, I was baffled that how come Sony did not advertise this camera as being also a dual ISO camera. Dual ISO means that you're going to have a two ISO values where camera maintains the same dynamic range and you know, the same brightness and the same characteristics at two ISO values. Well, it's, for me, it's kind of bizarre that was not included in the description, but actually probably this is not true. Like Alistair Chapman and other creators noticed, this is more like a dual sensitivity camera, which means that when you shoot in S-Log, your base ISO is 640, but when you go to 12800, the image becomes clearer. So there is some sort of a noise reduction applied, which makes the image look present, but the dynamic range is not the same. It's a little bit less. Now, mathematically speaking, this is not dual ISO, but dual sensitivity. Now, when you shoot RAW, you have to understand that there is not allowed to have absolutely no such type of noise reduction, sharpening, color transformation, or a crop, or any way, or any other way of altering the image coming right from the sensor. So that is the idea of RAW. The image is not good, right? So why would you have noise reduction in RAW? RAW files would always be noisier than S-Log that are processed in camera partially. Okay, but you have more bits to work with, not necessarily more dynamic range. So what people noticed is that when you go to in RAW in at ISO 12800, the image is not that clean as it was before. But when you shoot at 1600, the image is much cleaner. I don't know what happens in the past. Maybe that was not a true RAW image. Again, I found it bizarre even now that the image somehow gets clean at 1600 or whatever ISO value. In my opinion, this should not happen. We should not see any type of noise reduction in camera. Like, I mean, this should happen probably in post. When you edit the file, you should notice this, but not when you are observing on your FLT screen. This is kind of bizarre, but this is what it is. So we lost the 12,800 ISO, but we gained a clean ISO at 1600. Now, let's see what else I have discovered. And in order for that, to demonstrate to that, I'll be using my assistant, the DJI Osmo. What happens is, first of all, I will show you my setup. So this is the Sony A7S3. With the Atomos Ninja, we have a Amazon basic cable, HDMI, which is very good. It does the job perfectly. And my settings are, as you can observe, camera is in S-Log 3. I'm at ISO 640, f5.6, and 1/50 of a second. I have an external light source that is white balance to daylight. And if you remember my previous video, if we go to Lachman scale, this is kind of a false color code, but actually gets you the exposure in stops of light. If we going to use this, which is basically a data color SD card, and we observe the image here on the monitor, we can clearly see that the image is properly exposed because the gray card is at exactly 18%. So without any doubts, this is the correct exposure for the light situation. Now, obviously, the image may look different from Osmo to Sony that I'm recording, because they are different sensors, different gamma curves, and so on and so forth. But that's beside the point. Now, what I have noticed is, if you go into the menu, in the Sony camera menu, and we go into HDMI output, and we're going to select RAW output, okay? Obviously, the Atomos Ninja will reset. It will tell us now that it accepts a RAW signal, which is fine. Look, what I have discovered, and I want to share this with you. So the settings are absolutely the same. I'm at ISO 640 at 5.6 over 50th of a second. We're in ProRes RAW, compressed, doesn't matter. We're in Sony S-Log3 as gamut. This is the only thing that we can do. But look what happens now. If we are going into the Lachman scale, and we make sure we are in the Lachman scale, yes, we are. You see L zone here. If I'm going to raise my gray card, look what happens to the exposure. So I have the exact same settings, and the exposure is 3 stops brighter. Okay, so I repeat, the exposure is 3 stops brighter, which is absolutely bizarre. Now, if you do the math, ISO 1600 being the cleanest ISO, one stop extra is 3200, two stops is what, 6400, and three stops is exactly 12,800. This is absolutely crucial. So, from some error or some sort of a bizarre mathematical algorithm, I'm not sure what's happening, but when you're going to switch the camera from S-Log to ProRes RAW, and you're going to record through Atomos Ninja 5, because this is the only way you can get the RAW from the Ninja, from the Sony with the Atomos Ninja, the image becomes bright for the exact same settings. Now, which means that if you have two cameras, one that is shooting S-Log, the other one it's outputting RAW, for the same ISO, the RAW image is three stops brighter. So, it's like your 1600 ISO, that is the cleanest ISO now, it's equivalent to 12,800. Now, obviously, to adjust the exposure, you simply need to use more ND filtration, and a good ND filter should not change the quality of your image whatsoever. I'm not sure what's going on, but the image is definitely cleaner. We do not have two base ISOs, but we can probably record from now on at 1600 when you are in ProRes RAW and take it from there. You can probably get the camera back to 640. The image will become darker, but it will be also noisier. So I suggest to leave it at 1600. So this camera definitely is not a dual base ISO. Probably some sort of a dual sensitivity, or could be an error, or again with the new firmware update of Ninja. And I want to tell you that I'm at version 11. Some people did this test with an older firmware. Maybe well, the levels are again not correct in Atomos Ninja. It's hard to understand what's happening, but Lachman scale is very precise, and it simply shows me that the image is three stops brighter now. With this information, you do whatever you want. I think there are other creators that have better tools to approximate the dynamic range and the exact losses of gains with this new firmware update. I just wanted to make this short video to express my observation and to say that at the moment, I think ProRes RAW is still a viable option. The image is brighter. There's nothing wrong with that. And you should shoot probably in ProResRaw 1600 days and take it from there. I hope Sony officials will bring some light into that. And until next time, all the best.